Let's go! Today we're breaking down a few scrimmage clips from yesterday's practice and look. I am going to try and break this down as best I can. As you can tell, the audio isn't as great. I am currently on vacation, hanging out with Hayes family before the season begins. And look, today you're going to see these plays that you've probably already seen, but in a slightly different light after I was able to finally get a full evaluation of what actually happened. And, you know, come into this with an open mind. Remember, these are just practice clips. We are so close to actual game footage. So what we see is a limited sample of practice in a setting where you can't really hit anybody. So make sure you keep that in mind, okay? So now let's go on ahead and break down this practice footage. So you saw this play a minute ago, and if you watched our live stream, we played this play quite a few times. And honestly, this is some really, really good quarterbacking from Jayden Daniels. Right off a low snap, he steps up in the pocket and delivers a strike to Kyron Lacy. Now, so that means Jayden did absolutely everything right on this play, correct? Well, let's break it down a little bit further, okay? So first thing here is we get a really good rush from BJ. You can't really see it, but he does turn the corner right here a little too easy versus Anthony Bradford. But watch how Jayden just feels out this rush. We're getting a great pass block right here from Miles Frazier on Mason Smith. And watch how Jayden steps up in the pocket with two hands on the ball for extra ball security just in case they swipe down at him, and that's just excellent. And if there's something Jayden is the best on this team at, it's stepping up in the pocket and feeling out that rush. That is something that he has done against four-man rushes his entire career. That's probably his best trait, and he also doesn't just take off and run. He keeps his eyes downfield. Let's see the technique here. All cleats into the ground. You quarterback coaches out there, let me know what you think about the technique right here. But it looks pretty good from a novice QB evaluator here. And we get a really good throw, okay? But let's actually look at this a little bit deeper. All right, so let's actually talk about the receiver on this play. He's going up against Colby Richardson, and Colby is playing off coverage right here. And we need Kyron Lacy to beat him across the field here because, you know, essentially, he's giving us a free release right here to just beat him across the field. Now, Colby Richardson sees that this is clearly a dig or a crossing route, but what I want you to do is watch what Kyron Lacy does right here, okay? Boom. So he plants his leg and does what I like to call selling vertical. A lot of receiving coaches call it this term. So what Kyron Lacy actually does is he sells this dig route across here, okay? Some people call it, what is it, stair-stepping? Is that what it's called? Still, what that means is you act like you are going vertical to cause this defensive back to pause, because right now Colby Richardson is thinking dig, 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 dig. But now Colby Richardson sees that maybe, just maybe, Kyron Lacy might be going on a go right here. But instead, since he sells vertical with his head, you see how that forces Richardson to pause? And watch. Boom. Now, look at all that separation right there that created. It's separation, and this forced Richardson to pause, and that's why this throw was so easy for Jayden Daniels. That is excellent stuff right there by Kyron Lacy. Now, he did stumble a little bit, and you don't really want to see that. You want him to catch it clean and get upfield. But still, you did get that separation. He did. Now, the design of this play, and I don't have my dry erase board to actually draw this up, is actually really good. And I want to talk about somebody who, you know, is getting a lot of hype. But I believe this player's best trait is actually getting other people open, and that is Malik Nabers. Malik's just a good teammate, right? You saw this last year, even when he was hurt to start his true freshman career. He just always celebrated other people's success. And I don't know him personally. I'm not in that locker room to know that if he's like that all the time. But just watching him, he just seems like a very affable, good teammate. And what you'll see here is he actually opens this play wide open, okay? So what we're doing on the backside here is running two posts, okay? Malik, the slot, they're working him in the slot right now, especially with Jack not being there. Man-to-man against the slot receiver, okay, the slot corner. And you'll see right here, it's kind of cut off. You can see he gets behind him. But watch what Malik does. Because he gets behind him so easy, he draws the safety. And Joe Fouché, you can't really see him here. Fouché is having to occupy Malik Nabers, okay? Now, since Malik is holding the single high safety, guess what happens at the end of this play? Boom. BTJ is open, okay? So Malik drew the safety, and BTJ is wide open here for a walk-in touchdown, okay? So this is BTJ going up against arguably our most accomplished corner, and that is Jerick Bernard Converse, okay? So Bernard Converse, you know, just watching him over the past years, he does struggle with receivers that can get behind him, right? And that is exactly what happens here, okay? So I like JBC a lot. He's a very physical corner. But you'll see right here, boom, okay? So JBC right here is playing with what is called inside leverage, okay? You see how he opens his body right here to this side, okay? And he is daring BTJ to go around him. But watch what happens right here. BTJ, and it gets cut off once again, is able to get to the inside of him. This is excellent stuff. Pause. And you see, he's able to get behind him and hand fight him and get right here. Okay? Converse right here is beat. He is beat really, really, really badly right here. Okay? And now we are cooking with grease. Okay? If Jayden throws it right here, it's a walk-in touchdown. Now, that's why I said at the beginning of the play, it looks like Jayden did everything perfectly, and that's how I said it in the live stream last night. And honestly, he did. You're asking a lot on a long developing play for a quarterback to actually wait for that to open up. You don't know what rushers are around you. The issue, though, is if you do feel out that this is a four-man rush and the pocket is really clean, and if it looks like they are rolling into single high right here, you have to know that more than likely this single high safety is going to take the post from the slot receiver. So if the safety is getting occupied right here by the slot receiver, you also could potentially have a one-on-one situation to the backside, right? Once again, I can't actually draw this up because I don't have my dry erase board, but essentially put, pre-snap, Jayden potentially could have seen that the safety would have been drawn by the coverage by Malik Nabers. He was really good at drawing coverage. And by the way, we actually have a video of where Malik Nabers drew the coverage of Joe Fouché, and it opened up a big touchdown for Jeray Jenkins in the spring versus Jordan Tolles, who transferred, obviously. But if you want to see that play, it'll be floating at the top right corner of your screen. But that is exactly what happens here, okay? Once again, Malik draws his coverage, and we do get this open, okay? Now, the issue here is, would Jayden have had enough time to deliver this football, okay? And the answer is, yes, would have had plenty of time, okay? But it's hard to see that, okay? Especially if, and sometimes this happens, if a wide receiver that is running a more shorter intermediate route is beating a defensive back this badly, just take the sure thing, okay? This is so wide open, you're just going to throw it. I've talked to a few QB coaches about this. They said that's a perfectly fine throw right there, okay? But the better throw, the most optimal throw would have been this. And look, as a quarterback, you know, it's easy for us to sit where we're sitting and say, oh, this guy would have been wide open, and this guy would have been wide open. The read, your first read the whole time could have been Kyron Lacy, and you just got to throw it, right? So, once again, I don't know how it's coached. I don't know how, you know, you're actually working out, but it is interesting. So, once again, you give Jayden a 9 out of 10 on that play, but a 10 out of 10 would have been hitting the post on the backside for a walk-in touchdown. But that is where you become more advanced as a quarterback, right? If you would have seen that they rolled from 2 high to 1 high, you would have then thought Malik would have taken that safety on that double post, and you would have hit, I know I didn't probably explain that in perfect football knees, but you get it, okay? Let's go to another. Here we go. I really like this play right here. You're moving the back to this side. And this is what the Mike Denbrock offense is. There's a lot of lectures that he's done that you can find on YouTube from James Light called him talking about RPOs and glance RPOs, doing that of a 2x2 or a 3x1 formation. And I know this play was really tough to see from this angle, but let me show you this real quick. All right, so right here you'll see, and I'm not playing the actual video, this tight end actually goes in motion. What we're actually doing here is taking advantage of man coverage and using the speed right here of Desmond Ridder to our advantage. So tight end's moving right here, and this safety actually comes into the box, and this safety actually floats back here and becomes the single high safety defender. Okay, so now you see this after the snap. This is the safety all the way up here, and now all Desmond Ridder has to do is, if the safety plays him, he throws it right here in the flat. But Ridder sees that this safety is running hard with this defender right here, and obviously these defenders are occupied right here. So now Ridder knows all he has to do is beat the defensive end and run into this space right here, and that is exactly what he does. I know it's a little grainy, but you notice the safety ran all the way from here to here to this tight end. We got all this coverage drawn right here, and all we need Ridder to do is run into this space, and that is exactly what he's doing, and it turns out to be an absolutely massive game. You see Madhouse right here. I know it's not quite the same formation as the play you just saw, but it's essentially the same thing, right? We are trusting Jayden Daniels right here to beat a foot race with the contained defender, which here, it was actually Wes Weeks. He's caught up in here somewhere. Can't really see it. Does Wes Weeks actually make this tackle? I don't know. It's impossible to say from this angle. But all we needed Jayden to do right here is beat Wes Weeks. And look, there's nobody there. You know, there's absolutely nobody here to make this tackle. Good hustle by Cole to come get a piece of Jay Ward right there. And that right there is a really well-designed play. I know it doesn't look fancy. I know it's not, you know, something that we're used to really seeing an LSU offense do, but it is effective and it can tire out a defense. All right, so I gave Cole Taylor a lot of credit on that last play, but here, this is a massive, massive miss when it comes to this block right here. So right here, we get exactly what we want, okay? The contained defender is actually Savion Jones, and you notice he is lined up really tight, right? He is almost straight head up with the guard. So all we need to do right here is make sure he does not break or he doesn't get to Jayden Daniels quickly, right? We should be able to beat Savion Jones, who is a really good running chase defensive end, a lot like in the mold of, let's say, a Sam Montgomery. But watch what happens here, all right? We are showing play action, and you notice Cole Taylor is right here, all right? And maybe right here, Anthony Bradford, maybe Cole thought Anthony Bradford is going to get a little bit of a piece right here of Savion. Maybe Bradford should have, just to help Cole out right here. But Savion immediately sees that this is a play action fake, and he needs to get as flat as he possibly can. And Cole Taylor actually does something smart. If we were to allow Savion Jones to run to the quarterback, we want him to go to our inside shoulder because we trust Jayden Daniels to beat him in a foot race, but we still have to get at least a piece of him. And Cole is getting ready to make this block, and he whiffs him, okay? If you just get a little bit of a piece of him, you notice Savion didn't even have to break stride right here, all right? If we get a piece, look what's happening here. Sage Ryan is sprinting into this space. He's not even looking at Jayden Daniels. And Jayden obviously is looking to throw. And once Jayden sees all this space, he just needs to tuck and run this bad boy. Right here was a case where he probably shouldn't have kept his eyes downfield. If you see this much space, just take it. But he does pause, which is fine. And obviously Sage Ryan is cutting off this crosser right here. But you notice, because we missed this block, Sabian would have caught him, or it would have been close, okay? And he does, you know, hold up right here. So, you know, if you're Cole, at least you made him go to your inside shoulder, but you still want to get just a little piece of him to slow him down, and we miss out on potential yardage. I still think Jaden would have beat him to the corner right there. But still, you want to not whiff right there. All right, so if you love linebacker play, this is just really, really, really sexy stuff, okay? So what we're doing here is we're pulling Mason Taylor, and this is a key block in the Kelly Denbrock offense. Your tight end kind of sort of has to be a fullback, and what we're trusting Mason Taylor to do is destroy Mike Jones in this spot. Now, ironically, we did break down a clip where Mason Taylor and Deshaun Womack, one of LSU's best players of 2023 that's committed out of Maryland, go head-to-head. So I'm very interested here to see how Mason Taylor takes on this block right here of Mike Jones. And watch this. Boom! Look at how Mike squeezes down and sets this edge. This is actually really good right here for Mason. So this is kind of a push rep for me. But that is really good, right? You know, LSU's tight ends over the last couple of years, and right here we're actually in 12 personnel. So this tight end, this is, I believe, Nick Storrs, is crashing down to double this in right here. And what we are doing is we are hoping that Mason Taylor can kick out this backer. But the play right here was actually made by Wes Weeks, okay? Now, Wes, I saw this. He struggles sometimes scraping over the top, and he'll just run into the line of scrimmage. But watch here how he patiently waits this out, and instead of just running into the LOS, he scrapes over the top and just sits in the gap and makes this play. I'm guessing this tight end right here, Storrs, should have worked off this double and then got to Wes Weeks on the second level. And Bruce actually brought this up in our Patreon Discord, that these blocks are the toughest, you know, working off that double and then getting to the second level to the backer. And that's what happens here. Nobody blocks Wes Weeks. This is actually a decent kickout block right here from Mason. Good job by Mike setting this edge. And we just need Wes Weeks to scrape over the top like he did here and make this play, and that's exactly what he does. So, that was it, right? But as many of you know, Jaden Daniels wasn't the only quarterback. This was Miles Brennan right here throwing a great ball right there to Noah Kane, and this is Jaden Daniels throwing a great ball here to 38, I think a walk-on running back there. So, you know, for me, I want to do a Miles Brennan breakdown, but as you can see, I am on the road, and as you can see, I like to get very detailed. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make a promise to you. I'm going to get this Jaden Daniels film study out. As you can see, there is some extra stuff that I've already given to our Patreon that I'm not releasing here. A really good Mason Taylor breakdown that you could go see, patreon.com/LSU football. It's a good way for you to chat with me. And as you see, we have a patron Discord where we are just chatting about this stuff nonstop. And, you know, I've been spending a lot of time there, but really everything has been so crazy, right? We did a live stream from where I'm sitting right now. Obviously, you know, a little out of my element, and I'm sorry once again for the audio. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this out, and I'm going to try and get a Miles Brennan film study out as well, because I do want to talk about Emory Jones, right? He's got a lot of hype right now, and yeah, he played a lot with Miles Brennan yesterday, as did a lot of other players. So I'm going to try and get to it. Trust me, it's not anything against Miles, and I do want this to be discussed right now, okay? The QB discourse is getting too rancid. It's getting too toxic. And please breathe in and breathe out. Because as many of you know, there is one major wild card. There is no Garrett Nussmeier, right? He did not participate in the scrimmage, right? And we didn't even get to Walker Howard. But obviously we're focusing on these three quarterbacks and who is actually going to be the one that takes the first snap versus Florida State. Now, I will say one quick thing about Miles Brennan, and I'm not saying this just to say it. After watching just the scrimmage, now overall, I have heard different things about how Miles actually looks overall in practices, but just based on what I saw in the scrimmage, Miles actually played a little bit better than what I initially thought, and I'm going to try my best to get a film study out. So this Jaden film study is out right now, and we might release a Miles study right after this, so if you are watching this on premiere, just be on the lookout for that. Okay? Now, I'll also say this. My breakdowns are just the breakdowns, right? It's nothing personal against any player, anybody on the team. It's I love everybody, right? There's Mason Taylor right there again. Once again, if you want some bonus Mason Taylor content, go to Patreon, okay? Anything I say on here has nothing to do with anybody on the team, okay? I just want that to be clear, all right? It's just my honest evaluation. So I want each and every person on this team to succeed. None of this is just, you know, really even criticism. It's just what I am seeing. Once again, like I said at the beginning of the video, these are just practices. I'm not privy to the play calls. Obviously, the coaches are doing a bunch of experimenting to figure things out. But I will say this, you know, things do need to get cleaned up. And I think the coaches know that, right? And this is, you know, the first scrimmage of the fall that we were able to see. And hopefully some things do get better for LSU. So we shall see what happens. Comment down below your thoughts. And according to Blake, Jaden was actually 10 of 12 in the scrimmage. 10 of 12. That's some really good efficiency right there. So yeah, I like to see that. And pow, ow, LSU, bam! And tonight, ooh, some lasagna. Let's go.